Welcome back, folks, to more Let's Play La-Mulana. In this episode, I have no guest commentator, it is just by myself. Although I will admit that, you know, I really, really enjoy co-commentating with anyone. Just because it actually, you know, it makes it seem like I have more of a commentary to give because I don't specifically have to cater to talking about the game or about whatever else, so yeah. You're definitely going to see more videos like that coming in the future. I will tell you that much. It's because I really enjoy it too much, and if you're wondering what I'm doing right now, I accidentally forgot to solve that puzzle a while back, and it... Yeah, I really wanted to do that now. So, let's go back over here, and I say that it is high time to fight a sub-boss. Oh, and also as a side note here, I'm still using the desktop microphone because, well... I'm enjoying using it more because it gives me an opportunity to raise my voice without, you know, it picking up way too much in the, final recording. And this guy's pretty simple. All you have to do is just smack him down there and then smack him upside the face a few times, and that's pretty much it. So, that was easy enough. And it actually took me a little while to figure out that strategy, and it also took me a little while to realize that's an instant death trap. Way to go, Nagoro. You are being dicks. Okay, well, that was inappropriate language, but either way, let's break open that wall for a secret passage. And let's get shouted at in the process. That's just great. We can't do anything with that room for a while. And what I'd love to do right now is, well, simply go back to the spring of the sky and grind for a key fairy. Because we are about to go adventure... into grabbing what is known as the fairy clothes. Yeah, it's a goofy sounding name, but it's a very, very, very useful item to have because it cuts all damage you receive by half. And this is the only way to get it, so you're not a key fairy, you're a weapon fairy. I'll want you. So I've actually got a funny story about the fairies here. In one of my test recordings for... I think it was either this episode or, like, one of the ones I did before I started co-commentating with my girlfriend in the last few videos, I accidentally called a healing fairy a feeling hairy, and I laughed so hard at it because I was just like, really? I mixed up the F and the H. And after that, I decided to mix up the other ones, and I decided to mix it up with the luck fairy. And after that, I realized what happens if you say whenever you mix up the L and the F and that. So I'm just going to go ahead and say it. It's actually funny because it's called a fuck Larry. He's a jerk. Not going to lie, that was one of the better moments in a commentary that was potential. That I could have had. I wasn't even paying attention to the TV screen, and I realized I just got a key fairy because I was looking at how loud this commentary is going to be. I'm going to cut it down here. But I was realizing how loud it was going to be with the commentary on the new desktop mic. And as I was looking at the computer screen, I looked back to the TV screen and realized, oh, I just got a key fairy. That's awesome. So I didn't have to do hours of grinding, or, well, minutes of grinding. That feels like hours. Shouldn't that be feel like hours? I don't even know. Anyways, what we want to do is actually grab the key fairy and jump down here. Come on, key fairy, do your thing. That's right, go over to that chest. I want what is inside it. There we go. And we get the fairy clothes, which, as I've already said before, cuts all damage that we receive by half, which I don't think that it counts for... percentage damage things like the lightning bolts from the eyeballs or the spikes that you get hit by, amongst other things. But anywho, with the Key of Eternity that we got from that sub-boss fight, we can now venture throughout here, which is what I really would love to do. Oop, let's not get hit by Death Pollen, which is an obvious takeoff of Death Water. Well, in this case, it's Death Pollen. I don't even think that I've unlocked the shop in here, have I? No, I haven't. There we go. If you break that seal, then you open up a secret shop. Which, they actually sell bombs here, which is a Which is probably going to be the final sub-weapon that we get in the game, too. So, yeah, look forward to that whenever that happens in a while. But I didn't even know if that shop actually sold them. I wonder how much they sell them for. Because if they sell them for a cheaper price than where I already know where to get them, then, well, yeah, I'm probably going to start getting them there. And there we go. And with the Key of Eternity, we can do this! Summon a Shining Dragon. Oh boy, this puzzle room. Men are born of the mother and live their lives. They reproduce and reproduce, an unnecessary blue text, helping in the mother's ascension. So, born lives, reproduce ascension. I don't think that has any significance, but I'm probably wrong. And that goat obviously ate at Taco Bell. That goat is crapping out fire. That is disturbing. I'm gonna go around to grab that, because that's a full heal right there. Oh, no it's not. Alright, so anyways, for this puzzle room right here, you have to actually... I'll explain it really quick. Whenever you enter a new area of this game, you know, like you enter into the Twin Labyrinth, or you enter into the... what is it? Let's see, where else have I gone into? Like, you know, if you go into the Gate of Guidance, the Mausoleum of the Giants, Temple of the Sun, the entrances to all of those ruins have a marking near the entrance that you go to. And those markings are the La-Mulana language from 0 to 9. And what you're supposed to do in this room is go from 0 to 9. You're supposed to learn La-Mulanese and figure this out. That is 0. That is 1. Let's see. Oh, hello, full heal. Okay, that's number 4. There's another 0 if you wanted to go through that one instead. But I do not. Instead, I wish to destroy this block, which is how you're supposed to solve that puzzle and get the key sword. So I want to keep going over this way. Let's see. That's number 2 up here. Oop. Okay, well, I just got smacked by death pollen. Let's go around. And go over to the left. That is door number 3. So far we've gone through 0, 1, 2, 3. That's number 4, like I've already said before. I made a pun. And this is number 5. So now that we've gone through 5, let's go through door number 6. Which, if I remember right, you can actually skip door number 6. If I'm not sorely mistaken on that. So, if you want to, I think that you could just skip door number 6. I think I saw that in Deceased Crab's Let's Play of this game, which is, thanks to him, I actually started playing this game and I loved it so much. Well, here I am. Well, there we go. That's door number 7. Right below us is door number 8. Oh, come on. There we go. And then we have to go all the way down. And finally, over here to door number 9. And with that, we have solved this puzzle room, which was a really, really, really huge pain in my butt the first time I ever played this game. Like, I mean, it was ridiculously bad. I had to resort to the internet, man. Run through with all thy might, or rely on thy wisdom to find a way. Thou chooseth thine own path. Now place the weight. Words to live by. Do not look at the sun with the magnifying glass. There we go. The only reason why I destroyed that pot is because we got 2 chakrams in exchange. And those will come in pretty handy here soon. So, I would recommend doing that. So we place the weight there, jump around, find a secret passage, go down, kill off goat and snowman. Oh, come on. There we go. Get the twin statue, which is what is needed in order to access another area of the game here soon. And then finally use the Key of Eternity right here. All in 15 seconds, which, as you can tell, was very easily doable. Let's see, I want that equipped, and I want to go ahead and equip my chakrams. Wait, no I don't, not yet, that's too soon. So stick with the shield. Oh wait, I still need to use that. Endure the endless trials. That looks pretty scary, bro. Come on, go up. Don't hit me. Ah, you sausage. Dude, you're not supposed to jump up there. I don't like where that's going. Yeah, I figured as much. Okay, I'm not very good at this room, I'm not gonna lie. Because I kind of forget where some of the buzz saws are. And yeah, as you can see, they dealt out quite a bit of damage. If you didn't get the fairy clothes up at this point, they'll do a lot more. I'm pretty sure. So let's not get hit by that. Hey, see that headless ghost horse right there? While it's in that size, because they grow whenever you leave screen and come back on screen, like you see how it's tiny now, you'll actually be able to kill them. The other size that you'll be able to kill them on is if they're large, but if they're in that medium size, you can't do anything to them. They are invincible at that point. Oh! Now you see my eternal hatred for bats. Because they knocked me down and I got knocked into that warp point. Which is exactly what I was trying to avoid. Game, you can only push me so far before I get irritated. Like I've already said, viewers, La-Mulana is a fantastic game. Very, very wonderful and a lot of fun. But it goes without saying that it has a lot of frustrating moments. And yeah, I want to wait until that goes down and then go back over here. And there we go. Oh, who saw that coming? Because I did. Yeah, I'm going to wait this time. Or if it go up. Thank you. Are you going to move? No, you're not. How about you? Nope. Okay. Wow, I should not have jumped because I just chanced jumping into the spikes and taking a lot more damage. Yep, I sort of figured that was going to happen. Thank God for that grapple claw. Without it, I would have been hurting. There's a keyhole. Yeah, we've already got that. Let's go on ahead and use you and start going down before that buzzsaw hits me. Actually, I don't even think that would have hit me. Yeah, you see this right here? Do not read it yet. Trust me on this, viewers. You will thank me for it. Still Chinese zombie up there, which, if I remember right, that's where their origin comes from, was Chinese mythology. Yeah, I actually want that equipped. Oh, by the way, this is the final hallway of the Endless Corridor, so yay, rejoice! And get flaming poo shat upon you. Okay, turn around, and now I can murder you. Stupid headless horse ghost. I don't really care if it's itty-bitty. I'm gonna murder it. Do not hesitate when murdering your enemies, even if they are tiny headless horse ghosts. It's kind of disturbing and weird, but okay. All right, let's see. Okay, I did not want to do that. Oh well, good news is we got money out of it. And I do need a lot of that for later. Alright, let's see. Go on over here. And let's try and clear this room out of its bats. Ugh. Okay, there's one. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to really hit you, am I? Yep, not going to. Whoop! Okay, yeah, no, stop that. Go over here. I just wanted to kill the room, or kill off the bats in the room. That is all I really wanted to do. And go back over here. And now, viewers, it is finally time for us to, well, read that tablet. But unfortunately, I'm a little bit over the time limit that I was aiming for, so looks like I will be reading what this tablet says in the next episode of Let's Play La-Mulana. So I'd love to say thank you all for watching. I'll see you all in the next episode.